Hello and welcome to the session. Let's work out the following question. It says prove the following identity where the angles involved are acute angles for which the expression is defined. So let's now move on to the solution. And we have to prove this identity using the identity cosecant squared A is equal to 1 plus cot squared A. Now let's start with LHS, which is equal to cos A minus sin A plus 1 upon cos A plus sin A minus 1. Now since we have to use the identity cosecant square A is equal to 1 plus cot square A, we need to convert the whole expression in terms of cosecant A and cot A. So we divide the numerator and denominator by sin A. So we have cos A upon sin A minus sin A upon sin A plus 1 upon sin A upon cos A upon sin A plus 1 upon sin A minus 1 upon sin A. Now, cos A upon sin A is cot A. Sin A divided by sin A is 1. Plus 1 upon sin A is cosecant A upon cot A plus cosecant A minus plus 1, since here we have sin A. So sin A divided by sin A is 1, and here we have minus cosecant A. 1 upon sin A is cosecant A. Again, this is equal to cot A plus cosecant A minus 1 upon cot A minus cosecant A plus 1. Now we'll multiply the numerator and denominator by cot A minus cosecant A multiplying cot A minus cosecant A with cot A plus cosecant A, we'll be having cot square A minus cosecant square A. Multiplying cot A minus cosecant A with minus 1, we have minus cot A minus cosecant A upon cot A minus cosecant A plus 1 into cot A minus cosecant A. Here we have used the formula of A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. In this case, A is cot A and B is cosecant A. Now, cot square A minus cosecant square A minus 1 minus of cot A minus cosecant A upon cot A minus cosecant A plus 1 into cot A minus cosecant A. Here we have used the formula cot square A minus cosecant square a is equal to minus 1. Now again, this is equal to minus 1 minus cot a plus cosecant a upon cot a minus cosecant a plus 1 into cot a minus cosecant a. Now taking minus common from the numerator, we have 1 plus cot a minus cosecant a upon 1 plus cot a minus cosecant a into cot a minus cosecant a. Now this gets cancelled with this and we are left with minus 1 upon cot a minus cosecant a. Now again, cot a can be written as cos a upon sin a. Cosecant a can be written as 1 upon sin a. Taking LCM, we have cos a minus 1 upon sin a, and this is further equal to minus sin a upon cos a minus 1. Taking minus common from the denominator, we have sin a upon 1 minus cos a. Now multiplying numerator and denominator by 1 plus cos a, we have sin a into 1 plus cos a upon 1 minus cos a into 1 plus cos a is 1 minus cos square a, further equal to sin a into 1 plus cos a upon 1 minus cos square a is sin square a. So this is equal to 1 plus cos a upon sin a. Now we'll solve the RHS. RHS is cosecant a plus cot a. Now cosecant a can be written as 1 plus cot square a under the root of 1 plus cot square a plus cot a. As we know that cosecant square a is equal to 1 plus cot square a. Now again, cot square a can be written as cos square a upon sin square a plus cot a, that is cos a upon sin a. Taking LCM, we have square root of sin square a plus cos square a upon sin square a plus cos a upon sin a. Now we know that sin square a plus cos square a is 1. So we have square root of 1 upon sin square a. Plus cos a upon sin a. Now this is equal to 1 upon sin a. Now LCM is sin a, and in the numerator we have 1 plus cos A, which is same as LHS. We have proved above that LHS is 1 plus cos A upon sin A, and we have simplified RHS and we have obtained RHS is equal to LHS. Hence the identity is proved. So this completes the question and the session. Bye for now. Take care. Have a good day.